moment to plan. To fasten a collar. To try on a new pair of goggles. To listen to the advice of the mechanic. And then the time is all gone. The moment for which they have been preparing is here. And for the next 500 miles, each man will ride alone, doing the thing he knows best, driving a precision racing machine to win.
The traditional release of the balloon prior to the start of the race.
Start your race!
The pace car is pulling away. The first roll is away. All three cars moving behind the pace car.
Race car pulls into the pits. Jim Clark moves ahead on Foyt and pulls into the lead. Nervous drivers begin to settle down into driving patterns, which each individual man hopes will bring him into victory lane. Stop thinking about being first, for Parnelli Jones engages him in a duel which completely takes his mind off the front-running Clark.
Seconds from 11.
see the board display. Miami Jones driver, A.J. Foyt's crew indicated aboard to him that he was running 147 miles an hour.
The race roars on, 152 miles an hour average. The record book is being rewritten in this fastest 500.
Got to less than 5 seconds, but he's building it back up.
Carrying a light vehicle load, Connolly gambles on having enough to go the distance. This eliminates an all-out bid to catch Clark, who is 2 minutes ahead. Jimmy Clark crosses the finish line to become the victor of the 1965 Indianapolis 500. Jimmy Clark heads for victory lane and a winner's prize of more than $160,000. The fate of the front engine roadster is settled. The rear engine cars have completely revolutionized the racing picture since their introduction just 5 years ago. Jimmy Clark of Scotland becomes the first foreign driver to win since 1916. And his Lotus Ford is the first foreign car to win since Wilbur Shaw's 1940 victory in a Maserati.